I started working in Guatemala in 1984. I was originally drawn there by the finding of Jadeite jade there. The curiosity extended to questions of where did this stuff come from, how did it form, and it's really turned into a much broader Earth system study, trying to understand how the Earth works. The 2010 Niarchos Foundation's expedition to Guatemala was to go to central Guatemala to investigate a variety of geology related to my research on what's called the Guatemala Suture Zone, which is the boundary between the North American tectonic plate and the Caribbean tectonic plate, and it records how the Caribbean moved into its present location. We went to a place we'd never been before in far eastern Guatemala, towns of Hocotan and Camotan, where a colleague of ours told us, oh, I found some rocks there that we would call an ophiolite. It's basically a piece of seafloor crust that had been emplaced on top of the continent. This body has not been described in the geological literature. If you look in the maps of Guatemala, it doesn't exist. So just to be able to go and find something brand new and try and fit it into the puzzle of the geology is important for us to understand what's going on. The context for jade and the context for a lot of the rocks in the valley is what's known as a serpentinite melange. What it is pieces of the Earth's mantle that have been hydrated. Water's been added to them and they change their mineralogy into serpentine. And serpentine is the host for most of the action, the kinds of rocks that we're interested in. Jadeite is a relatively rare mineral that forms at high pressures, pressures that are really only produced in subduction zones. Basically, subduction zones, pieces of oceanic crust dive under some other part of the Earth, and water is liberated from the wet, subducted crust, and that permeates the overlying crust. And part of what it does is create jadeite, but the other part of what it does is create the volcanoes that we see, for example, all around the Pacific. There are a lot of little connections that we're trying to put together in this research. And the project has gotten larger because now we're trying to understand, how did things work there? How did this happen? There are two belts of jadeite which don't make any sense with respect to one another. Now we know they have different ages. One's about 150 million years old and the other's about 70 million years old, 90 million years old. They're two totally separate terrains that are just now pasted next to each other. And we still don't fully understand how that happened. And so a lot of our research now was to help resolve some of this other geological puzzle. Right now, we're doing isotopic geochemistry and trace element geochemistry on these rocks because those trace elements and their isotopes tell us what was the process, what was the composition of the fluid that went from the subducted slab, the same fluid that forms jadeite, and then winds up making jadeite and then also continuing on into what becomes serpentinite.
I bring back a lot of samples. I bring back every different type of rock that I found. I study the composition of these rocks and I compare with rocks from other areas to see what is their origin, if they form in the middle of the ocean, in the form in an island arc, or they form in a hot spot like Hawaii, or they form in an arc like the Marianas. So I compare my data with localities well known around the world, and we know where they form. And then I try to explain how they ended up there. So it's very exciting, it's like detective work.
Every trip, we learn something new. Every trip, we find new places where we haven't found jade or we found rocks that people said were different than they actually are. So it's the kind of thing, you have to be on the ground, you have to go, you have to collect, you have to bring rocks back to the museum, study them in detail, work with others. We have a broad collaboration of people in other universities to study this. And it's also open windows for their research in other parts of the world.